Welcome back, everybody. Game number two of VG Gaming Reborn versus VG Gaming in the Epicenter Chinese Qualifiers. VG Gaming Reborn are up one game, just ever so barely, but they did manage to clinch the win in game number one after what was... they controlled that game through and through for full 20 minutes, but you might have made a slight error with a certain buyback and dying, and it was a whole thing that ended up in a base race. But still, Reborn did manage to stay out on top, and VG Gaming most assuredly need to be able to pull out some sort of different strategy or better execution or something, because that game one was pretty rough to watch for the first 20 minutes. Let's get into game number two now, where I have Montpax, who's going to be joining me with a first pick bounty hunter on VG Gaming.
Woohoo! All right, so we'll get a little bit more aggressive roaming. Going to be watching out for maybe those FY Night Stalkers causing a little bit of issues, and of course those Enchantresses as well. I mean, you got to love a team that's got a flair for the dramatic, right? That's all that was, I assume. You know, and ZYF, the buyback, he's like, yeah, I'll give him a chance. Throw him a bone. He'll be fine. So I was... I had a little bit of time to think about the draft, thanks to some slight delays, and I still just, I can't get over that Evoker and the PL. Like, what happened there? Like, what was the plan to deal with a mid-PL? Because there's no way they didn't think about it. I mean, we called it as the third pick of the entire draft for VGR, and then you go ahead and pick a Lina and a Witch Doctor who had just no chance of helping the Evoker or shutting down the PL.
Yeah, I have no idea. I'm sure that kind of drafting error won't be made again by ROTK. That seemed to be just... I don't know. Is it possible? Has Reborn run Phantom Monster mid before? I'm sure they have, right?
They did during the qualifiers for this, but in all fairness, they also weren't ticketed, so
yeah.
There's no record of it. So if you actually look at their games, they hadn't run it in a while. They were more into those other mids that we talked about, but... the same time, it's just like, yeah, it had been, 5 days. There's so many damn games that it's just like they were running it. So, I don't know. Pretty crazy to me. VG Gaming's
turn to pick. All right. Well, we finally get Reborn's picks here for the first two. It took them a while, but they're going to go for their Enchantress and Sven. Something that VG Gaming, I believe, banned out last game with the Enchantress, that is.
Yeah. I believe she replaced the Prophet, and other than that, it was the... who else was the Beastmaster replacing? I'm not sure. But either way, we won't be seeing the lone druid. Well, maybe we'll see it here for VG Gaming. I don't know. Do you think Burning wants to hop back on that? It went pretty well.
Yeah, I would say so. I think that's still a solid pickup. But then again, you're dealing with an Enchantress this time around, and that is one of those problem heroes that you have to kind of draft around. So maybe a different carry is in order. Maybe something like a Klinx, a Doom. Okay, I'm okay with Doombringer here.
Yeah, that's some China stuff right there. First phase Doom.
Yeah. Burning Gyrocopter is not great versus Sven necessarily, but it's pretty aggressive and it does deal with the Enchantress. 10 seconds remaining.
So since Shanghai, and since the Darkseer pick of that was almost a month ago now.
Oh god.
CTY.
It's a pocket strat, guys. Woo! What a pocket strat that was.
That was something else. But he's only been playing OD. He's played mostly OD, 5 games. He's got some PL going on and then some Invoker, and he dabbled in some Ember Spirit. So pretty standard stuff, had one Death Prophet game. I'm wondering, are they going to go back for the Invoker? It seems like VG Gaming Reborn, they are respecting the CTY OD. Not too surprising. Hero's pretty crazy right now. So if Invoker's left in the pool, I think that's pretty solid. They don't really have those, nice supports to help out with it, though, in terms of a, actually being able to lock someone down and hold it. I suppose if you go for, the Troll Trap with Doom, it might work. But then they have to ban PL here, if that's what they're thinking. Remaining. And then I wonder if VG Gaming are just, they're just going to take the Invoker for themselves, I'd imagine. 5 seconds remaining.
An Dire early ban here back. From the Broodmother.
Yeah, they're just going to ban it and take it. That's exactly what's going to happen. I'm not liking this draft. And it's just so, it's so readable, but... I mean, maybe it's only because I've lost the respect for ROTK of the first game and the fact that, we saw the things coming and we're okay, they're intentionally giving to them, so... again, I'll assume this is intentional. And then how are you going to, like, apply your own pressure to the Invoker this time without your PL? Like, you have the Bounty Hunter, so that's a great step, but what kind of a mid can you give to CTY where you can actually make something happen here? Mm-hmm.
10 seconds. There's not a whole lot of mids left. Oh, they do go for the Ursa. All right, good choice.
Solid.
I was actually expecting, like, almost maybe, like, a Spectre from Burning or something like this. I think that this pickup is much stronger. I didn't actually expect VG Gaming to draft it, but they do go for the Ursa. Great hero against Enchantress is actually pretty damn good versus Fen, and it's okay versus Invoker. Invoker does cause some issues with all melee carries, though.
5 seconds remaining.
Yeah, I do like it against the Enchantress and the Sven, though. That's pretty good. It's hard to find anyone that can actually help deal with that Sven, so... That's, I assume that'll be for Burning, and we're not getting, like, some mid-CTY Ursa, but you never know. Maybe he's just, like, really misses the hero. It's like, yeah, like, give it to me, man. I'm tired of this stuff.
Lion. I was about to say, I think Lion is the most obvious pickup for Reborn at this point. You need a heavy disabler to couple with your Enchantress, and it's a hero that can cause issues for Doom and Ursa. And it's also a hero... You need heroes that are going to be self-sufficient against Bounty Hunter. Now, a lot of times that means, you know, picking up something that has a lot of tank and that can man fight against a Bounty Hunter, but it could also mean just having multiple avenues of disables, which Lion does, obviously. VG Gaming are going to go for the Witch Doctor. It's an okay pickup versus Enchantress. The Death Ward is really good. Sometimes the Paralyzing Cask can ease some of the pressure from the laning phase, but most of the time, good Enchantresses will just separate themselves from their actual creep, their hard camp creep that they're pulling in, and it's not actually going to give you that much relief. So while the Enchantress may be able to be dealt with mid-game thanks to the Death Ward, I think you're still kind of concerned about some of her pressure that comes out from just having that Enchantress for a position in general. I'm wondering what kind of offlaner they're thinking about, though. I would love to see something that pairs really... I would almost say, like, a Faces Void would not be that bad of a pickup here to control the Ursa. Any disables that are able to control the Ursa and ignore Enrage, I think, are pretty valuable.
Yeah, you're missing a lot of synergy of, like, the Darkseer. There's nothing that's really that great. Enchant is probably, like, the worst four role that kind of fits with the Darkseer. I guess they're going to ban it anyway, but... yeah, I like the Tidehunter or the Faceless Void. I think either's totally solid here. If you're so good at Faceless Void when you get those, like, really peak Chronos, you know, and when the Chrono hits just right, and Sven can come in and do his thing.
Yeah.
That's the good stuff right there.
Yeah. And you've got Invoker and an Enchantress who both synergize really well with that kind of great AoE disables. I personally prefer...
anything that good against it.
I personally prefer Void just because Ursa is problematic for a Tide in lane, but I think they both have their kind of pros and cons. Tide's better versus
like
Doom.
Way more. Yeah. More survivable. Yeah. Reserve
time. And it would be a mech hero as well. Weaver. Whoa! All right, that's a little bit of curveball. Elastic Weaver. Turn to pick.
So, who's he going to be up against, though? I mean, obviously the Ursa. Okay, I guess that makes kind of sense, right? Like, it's hard to stack the Fury Swipes on top of him, get those multiple hits. He's going to be weaving around in and out, you know, doing his thing.
He'll build Lincolns against the Doom, which is so far their only solid disable against a Weaver. Paralyzing Cask is obviously quite poor. 10 seconds
remaining. His early game's going to be hard. He's going to be really cautious about like the Bounty Hunter. That might be where he might draw some of that pressure from the mid, too, possibly, just because Weaver's a little bit fragile early on.
Reserve yeah.
Time. This is a very important pick here. It'll be that tiny. So they've done this, again, without the IO previously. All right. Oh, wait, no, the CTY. Okay.
Yeah, the CTY mid-tiny versus Invoker. It's going to be a little bit rough, but it's going to be super reliant on Bounty Hunter to be able to set up kills or maybe just create space for the tiny in these first couple of levels.
I haven't actually seen this one. So you could do Bounty Hunter sitting under your own tower, and then you do the toss back if you ever get in range of the Invoker. Mm-hmm. You just, like, sit invis.
Yeah. The biggest problem is getting there in the first place, right? Because Invoker is usually able to keep good distance against a Tiny. Particularly if he goes the Forge Spirit build. Because he really abuses Tiny's no armor. That's very problematic for the Tiny. But it's all on JDH to essentially make plays and set things up. Meanwhile, I don't know. I'm feeling pretty favorable to Reborn's lineup. I did not expect the Prepare Weaver, but battle. I can see why they picked it up. I think I still prefer the Faceless Void, but Weaver is quite strong, I think, still.
I feel like, again, it's going to kind of come down to what Arotike, like, how much pressure he can actually draw. Because last game, he didn't really impact the laning stage at all. He just left, went to the jungle. You got a ton of farm on DDC as that 5 roll. It left FY totally able to farm the entire time. This time, he'll probably be a lot more aggressive because he's going to be on the Enchantress rather than that Night Stalker. But DDC got a ton of farm, too. Like, he was basically, like, combined net worth of the two VG supports. And if that happens again, where they can just zone him out once more and he has to run into the jungle, I'm worried about VG's early game.
Oh, you know something? Lion is actually super good versus Doom offlane. We haven't seen Doom offlane in a really long time, but I remember this now. The problem is that Doom is so dependent on his mana, right, for survivability, Scorched Earth. But he has such a limited mana pool, it's super easy.
Oh, yeah.
Like, Lion literally hits one impale, like, level 2. You go Earth Spike and Mana Drain. You impale him once, you Mana Drain him down, he's gone. Like, he probably has to pop Scorched Earth just because he needs to use his mana before you take it away from him if you're in the right position. It's so hard for... I think this is probably alleviated by Mangos. I think maybe that, because this was obviously back in the day when Mangos weren't really a thing. When Doom offlane was more prevalent. But maybe Mangos could help out in that situation. I understand RTK going for boots first. I think it still makes a lot of sense in this matchup, but. Maybe if he dies or something, it has to go back to base. I think a Mango could actually help him out quite a bit.
Yeah, this is, like, actually brutal. The low mana cooldown, you don't really consider Doom's having, like, mana problems, but it is really because of just how cheap everything is for him, right? Mm-hmm. You look at these costs and you're like, oh my god, he's only got 13 in. That sounds awful. So, yeah, maybe gonna be doing a little bit of jungling here. Maybe he'll hang out in the jungle for a bit, get a creep, maybe kill a camp or two, and then head top. We've seen that a couple times against rougher matchups.
Yeah, I think actually that is part of the plan. Because the mid matchup is very hard for CTY and he needs a lot of help in the first four levels. Between the Bounty Hunter and the Doom, they might actually be able to do to hook him up, essentially. So maybe the Doom does do what you're saying. Like, he jungles very early on and he does the run at you play against Nono. Who has no can awards. FY's got him, though. Looks like FY's going to maybe pass off. He can return to the middle lane if this can award does get taken away. JDH. Oh, JDH doesn't have counters. Okay, that's really bad.
Yeah, this has been happening with all the bounty hunters in China. Like, I was casting the prequels, and this was happening all the time. And what I was noticing a lot of the time was it just meant that the bounty hunter didn't actually end up staying in the mid lane. Now, I don't know about this time, because this seems like a pretty important time for JDH, but a lot of the time they just wouldn't bring counters, and they would instead, like, almost try and bait out the sentries mid and then go force their attention into the off lane. But maybe it's because he's going to be chasing down FY.
Yeah, it seems like that's what he's going to be going for. He has to make his way. The problem is with bounty hunter versus junglers now is the off lane camp opens up a lot of fresh avenues for Chantress, Enchanted
they have the
Enchantress.
Toss back mid. No, I can't get it.
Not quite. Bottom lane, Yang does finally get spotted out. He's been sitting in the trees here for a little while. He's just going to deal some damage to HYM and actually take some damage. Oh, Jesus. That should have been a Shikuchi
Oops.
Popped a lot faster.
Can they kill HYM? They have the salve.
Yeah, maybe. Yang's got the Shikuchi, but FY's not quite going to be able to get that kind of positioning.
Yeah, the enchant was on cooldown, so.
Yeah. I'll tell you, my packs, I've been learning a lot of Bounty Hunter lately. I spent, like, the last 2 or 3 days exclusively watching some of the Bounty Hunters from the Shanghai Major and then just playing a lot of Bounty Hunter. And this is not the play.
No,
this is not the play whatsoever. JDH is having no impact so far. They are going to get a really good paralyzing cask. Unfortunately, that bounces over to the other neutral camp, and that may actually prevent them from killing FY a little bit more, and they do get it. First blood goes the way of HYM. Again, something about enchantresses separating themselves from their creep. That's pretty important, as you can see why.
Yeah, almost got lucky with that bounce, but not quite there, so... All right, well, solid stuff. Yeah, we've been having a little bit of a struggle. I feel like the more Bounty Hunter has risen in terms of, like, overall prowess, it's just the fact that teams are a lot better at dealing with it. You don't generally see that many courier snipes anymore. They kind of wait, you know, until they see where the Bounty Hunter is before bringing up the courier, and so it's harder to make that impact when teams are more aware.
Yang, Shikuchi's away. Witch Doctor with the Invis Rune. I'm sure that was information was passed off to him, so... He's going to play it pretty passive for the next few minutes. CTY's doing not so bad, honestly. He's doing really, really well. 15-4 compared to 11-2 on No-No. I'm rather surprised. He is going for the Quaswex build on No-No's Invoker rather than the Exort build. But I think either build, it's a little bit surprising to me that the Invoker's doing so well.
Yeah, you would think he'd be kind of getting bodied here. That bounty rune, though, so it should be helping there.
Nice rotation. JDH actually positions himself beautifully to spot FY's smoke through mid.
Oh, that's pretty big.
And that'll pretty much ruin everything for FY's game.
Okay. Oh, right. Oh, wrong side here. We're good. Jeez, I was watching FY on, he was on the Bounty Hunter yesterday, and he had, like, the stopwatch going on the courier, man. Just like every time that thing came out of the base, just like dead.
DDC actually went for the Hex here against this Doom. RTK is level 4 already. And he managed to get Frost Attack combined with also going the Infernal Blade, which is quite common when you go for this Boots build on Doom. The China Doom, it just kind of like, it always gets Boots first and it jungles a little bit and then it just runs at you. The China Doom has gotten so much better now that you get a slow from this Infernal Blade. Ever since they instituted that skill, DDC, very dead.
Yeah, man, China's all about that Doom. Like, yeah. I believe it was during the pubs during Shanghai, everyone was talking about how highly they value it. And since then, it seems to be continuing. Like, plenty of these first phase Dooms that we're seeing right now have been picked up in these Chinese qualifiers that are starting to come out here, so... It's always interesting to find kind of that regional flavor, but this one's like pretty far out there. Most squads in the western side of the world only really run.
It bounced back to him. He does manage to get the ghost walk, though. No, it's now going to turn on CTY. The Voodoo Restoration might be able to keep him alive. No, that's just not the case. The Hex gets the last bit of control necessary. Invoker will head back to base. Meanwhile, bottom lane, FY, not sure what's happening here, but it's something crazy. They get the Hellbear Smash, slowing down Burning enough, and Yang, he might be able to pick up... Burning's just going to keep on going. He might be able to kill the FY, but it's probably going to cost him his life as he's got so much minus armor at this point in time. He will end up going down to Yang, and the Bounty Hunter is just sitting there on the side, knowing that he can't really do anything about this.
Jeez, it's so hard to make out these TPs and everything through the China. I'm getting a little bit of the old perfect world here.
Yeah.
But it's all right. All right. Okay. All right. What do we got then? So Ursa obviously dropping down here. Man, Yang. This is pretty sick start for him. Only 16 last hits. A little bit disappointing. Jeez, how about this Sven? God, ZYF again. He's got Helm, Boots, Mango, 6 minutes. Definitely going to be the SMY build again.
Yeah. Also, the Ursa's tower got taken by 6 minutes. Maybe Weaver is, like, the answer to the safe lane Ursa. I didn't expect it to be this good. Oh, with the Enchantress, they're doing a lot of work here. JDH, oh, God. Barely gets outside of the range of that counter ward. On 18 HP, will be able to get away.
Yeah, that's, I mean, I guess with any sort of a pairing, too, right? Like, the Enchantress is probably one of the best ones. She is kind of that, like, best dual in-game or in-lane kind of pairing that you can really ask for. Like, even better than, I think, the Doom or your Earth Spirit roaming around or something like that to help out your offlaner. Enchantress just offers everything you could ever ask for. It looks like mid lane, they're trying to set up with a smoke here, getting really aggressive with Burning this time. He's kind of doing the ZYF play, you know, getting out of that lane early. Try and make something happen, but... Oh, they are not going to be lucky this time.
No, they're certainly not. If they go up to the top lane, they're going to be rather disappointed because ZYF has completely abandoned his safe lane as he has wanted to do. I think Vici Gaming maybe expected that, and that's why they tried to go for the smoke deep into the jungle. But unfortunately, ZYF is at the offlane camp, and if they gank top, it's just going to be a DDC Lion.
Oh, man. The plays, like, just working out so well here. They perfectly predicted what he was doing. They were correct. Roams on past to find Nimbus room. Invisibility. But we'll just trade jungles here.
And now he just God strength through the jungle once again. While bottom lane's pushing out, they've got to rotate soon if they want to be able to put a stop to this one. Looks like they're still going to try and take this tier 1 tower, but it's not really a necessity. Reborn are gladly going to give that one up.
Man, this pressure. They're just continuously batting around. Like, what are they going to do? Are they going to TP down? Is Lion going to cancel the TP at burning? DDC just sneakily playing it out here.
JDH just threw a shuriken at a Satyr, and it did not die. It ended up timing out, so he didn't get anything out of that.
Yeah, he's still sitting on level 4. He never paired up really with the Doom, which is a little bit surprising. It's kind of one of those ones that you'd be looking for.
Yeah, exactly. That dual lane should be incredibly powerful. Orb of Venom, run at them with Scorched Earth. If you get level 4 on Doom relatively early, you get the Infernal Blade as well, and that's like slows on top of slows. They could easily run down and get a couple of kills on someone like the Lion.
Yeah, I don't know if they're going to go for this here. HYM lurking. ZYF playing very safe last game as well.
Yeah, but I really again, like this.
You can just go for that same rotation. Man, that smoke, that's actually such a key point in this game. The fact that they committed so much to that and they were so close. I mean, they were like 20 seconds behind him. He had just like made the crossover of cleaning the camps to here. That's tough.
Yeah, his rotations have been so smart. The part where he went down into the enemy jungle while they were pressing the bottom lane, and as soon as the rotation was forced down to the tier 2. He TP's mid, and then he gets the deny, and he goes right back to jungling. No-No, they tried to throw the Doom out on him, but No-No was faster with the Tornado and EMP combo. ROTK now completely out of mana.
Oh my god, he's so slippery. Like, they can't see why. He's just juking and jiving through the trees here, and now back to the safety of his tier 2 tower. And on the other side, look where his teammates are. Again, they're just pressuring this tower.
They have the dust, too. They're going to be able to spot out JDH. This very dead.
No response. I mean, this is kind of your mid-tiny issues. Like, you can't exactly head in there. Doesn't have a TP anyway, but he wouldn't have the mana to do anything. Not the most reactive heroes.
And Doom never has mana. Oh, boy. He just went from mid lane where he got Tornado EMP'd, then he popped to Clarity, came bottom, devoured. He used one skill, Devour, and then he's out of mana once again.
Oh, man. I'm getting a little worried here. Yang is getting way more farm than I expected in this offlane Weaver, keeping up right with the Ursa. And then you gotta wonder, like, CTY, he's already got those Arcane Boots. I assume this will be the Blink build, and he'll be going for, like, kind of those Force Staffy plays even after, potentially, but the earlier you get it, obviously, the more potent it's gonna be, and it's great against Weaver. Doesn't really matter about the Lincolns, you can actually still get these kills. Level, like, 10, you can easily burst him down with a single go, but you gotta actually get that item up and rolling, you know? It's 11 minutes here, and he's not really that close. Oh man, this would be a big kill.
They're gonna lose their tier 2 and CTY at the same time, it seems. The impale combos up beautifully. They're gonna use the Finger of Death, and EMP finishes them off. No-No picks up the kill, and the tier 2 tower does end up going down in the bottom lane.
Alright, this is like total disaster. I don't know, maybe it's not that bad. It's looking pretty damn bad. You've got Sven sitting on top, followed right up by No-No. Your Tiny just died, and he's also off the map for 35 seconds, so he can't farm. You already saw what N/ZYF is going to be doing, like, last game on the Sven. Total free farm. He's got a nice little stack just waiting for him. Maybe stack that up once more. Go pop that right into his full-load SMY. Get aggressive with the Blink and pair up with your Enchantress and your Weaver. He can really make whatever decision he wants. DDC's farmed. Like, you committed to this Doom and this Bounty Hunter that haven't really had a big impact yet.
Yeah, this is looking like a pretty clear strategy win from Reborn, both when it comes to their draft as well as their execution. Very much on point. Reborn are no longer going to have that stack available to them, as that did get countered away. But everyone else is farming so fast that it doesn't matter if this Sven doesn't get like that gigantic net worth lead that he usually has thanks to ancient stacking.
Yeah, and they're all just kind of hanging out, I think, just trying to guard the Roshan pit too, because really that's the only way to get back in.
ZTY ends up going down. It's a well-executed gank. You know, that's a pretty nasty combo. I think Swarm procs Cold Snap.
Yeah, there's a lot of those really disgusting ones you can pull. There's like the Doom with the Cold Snap. He just like runs in on you.
Yeah.
That's some really annoying stuff.
Now ZYF, he popped his God Strength earlier, I presume, yeah, to clear through the Ancient stack, and they decide against pressuring mid. I think it's the right choice. They're not far enough ahead that they can, like, guaranteed win fights or anything like that, so Reborn should just continue to play the movement game, and once they get, like, a 10,000 gold lead, then they can really easily force 5 versus 5s under enemy tower.
And ZYF, he's just, like issuing out the patrol commands here for his creep. He's like running it in, he's checking out the rune every time, he's always going into the Roshan pit over and over just to make sure the Ursa's not in there. Mm-hmm. All while he's farming away. Like, this is such solid stuff coming out from them. And the Bounty Hunter and the Doom have honestly been inside this circle for the past like 4 minutes. They're just like hanging out mid. They couldn't even save CTY's life though.
That's not been great for them so far.
Alright, well, FY, he's going right into what appears to be the old dragon. You know, get that lance up and rocking.
What a cheap item for Enchantress that increases your damage by so much.
Yeah, it's ridiculous. It's like eggs on steroids. Cheap, cheap, dirty, back alley steroids.
TP out. And they only lose their Satyr in the meantime. The counter ward finally does get found by DDZ.
This is really interesting, like the positioning from VG. The fact that they're not going for any sort of like a smoke play because they feel like our Ursa needs to be farming. He's trying to get up into that Blink Dagger, so CTY at the same time. And you don't have like this option of a lot of teams, I think, would try and get aggressive right now. They wouldn't try and farm this out, but the positioning of ZYF all the time, like people are generally nearby him, the way that he's rotating in rather safe ways. I don't even know if that would be possible, so maybe this is the right move, but you can kind of feel them slipping.
Yeah, it's something about the Radiant side that just, like, facilitates more conservative plays. I mean, you could really see it's playing against VG Gaming right now, where they need to be aggressive, but every single time they attempt to, Reborn, quick to strike, get a pick off on the Bounty Hunter. And they're controlling farm decently well. In fact, if they pick off Burning here, it's going to get even worse. Burning immediately going to pop the Enrage and go for the TP out. That's going to be stopped by a Cold Snap. CTY managed to get the Blink in, though, on Nono. With the help of the Death Ward, they will manage to pick up that kill. Very important turnaround there. Yang does actually get doomed up, but I think DDC is going to be able to save him here. Or not. CTY actually blinks forward ahead of the Impale. Impale complete whiff there, and CTY will chase down Yang, avalanching him to death. There is finally the turnaround that VG Gaming desperately needed to be able to get back in this game. Unfortunately, it does cost them a tier 1 tower, where ZYF, and he's already got that S and Y. Radiant's top tower
is under attack. Oh man, CTY just so thankful that he had that Blink Dagger right there. It's like the ideal positioning, the ideal dive to come out from VGR, just being able to punish that there. So Burning did die, but it's okay. He's got his Blink Dagger. He's ready to rock. They can help secure the Roshan pit just by giving CTY like a much bigger area of impact all the time. And so maybe a little bit more respect will be shown here from VGR. Man, look at these sentries too that they've got going out here though. They're just making sure that there is no blocks coming out on top of this ancient camp.
Yeah,
there's
they
no
missed
the bounty to go.
They missed it the first time. I think this is the most common ward. Just because this little lip here that allows you to put it up on the cliff. I think that's always kind of your go-to spot now. But he missed it the first time. And unfortunately, he only had one counter ward, so he had to go back, pick up another set. It was a whole process. But The ancient stack is ready to go, and it's so easy for the Dire to be able to control that when they still have both of their tier ones up at bottom and mid.
Yeah, C2Y up top, but unfortunately, not gonna have. Well, actually, he will have the mana here. Oh no, that's too bad. Yang's just on his way out. Alright, well, no gank potential coming up here. What level is he?
He's what, level. What the hell? Yeah. Is this. Have you seen this before?
Etherlens? What's happening?
Etherlens Tiny?
Oh, yeah. People have been turning the Arcane Boots into it. I guess because people like. You know how you used to go like Arcanes into the Blink Force Staff? It's uh-huh. kind of like the meme, like Dagon back yeah. in the day. I think it's just that. Wrong neighborhood, okay. JDH.
That went well. Alright, I'm not gonna say I'm down.
I'm not
with
sold
it,
on either. Yeah.
We'll see. So what was that? What does that upgrade your toss range to? His toss range is actually absurd. That's affected by Aetherlens, right? As well as Avalanche.
Yeah. Where are you going? The Avalanche is the big one, I think.
Yeah. FY gonna be bursted down in the bottom lane. But VG Gaming Reborn are going to be able to respond here with a quick kill on RTK. Paralyzing Cass. They still manage to get the Tornado EMP off on CTY, but they do toss him up in the air, and Burning quickly eats the Invoker alive. Doom buys back as ZYF was being kited around, attempting to go for that kill, but not going to be able to make it. Tries to get himself out now. Looks like he's fast enough with a Warcry. Burning blinks ahead. Barely had enough mana for that one, but he doesn't have enough for anything else, and it looks like ZYF is going to be able to get away. Toss forward, long range toss over to Burning, trying to get the Paralyzing Cast, but this is just a bad idea. You're diving into a Tier 1 tower. And VG Gaming do have to back out, but again, a successful trade-off for them.
Yeah, they have almost totally owned DDC.
DDC
well.
Got tossed back by CTY with a blink forward. Death Ward will finish him off, and that's another track kill. Let's not forget, not only is Reborn ahead, so trade-offs are well worth it for VG Gaming, but they also have this Bounty Hunter track gold that's going to be coming into play.
Yeah, they've majorly stemmed the bleeding here. Like, if you look at the net worth graph, you can see that not only is it starting to go level, it's starting to come back, but the bigger part is the fact that although you're getting gold up on all your cores mostly here on the side of VG, on the side of VGR, the graph, it's staying level, but that's only because of ZYF, so it's like the Sven's getting up there, but at the same time, if you ever just bring down the Sven, the rest of that team's going to be pretty underwhelming in comparison. Radiant's middle tower is under attack. More Ancients, though. That BKB coming out soon here for him.
JDH. FY stutter stepping there was almost in range for the impetus shot. Now he may actually be caught by Burning. Burning actually starts running the other direction away from the Enchantress at just the wrong time.
Yang top lane on each one of them. Goes to the TP, so he should be alright. Got that point booster for the tank. Yeah, FY, he's been pretty quiet for the past while. Just kind of doing all. He looks like an offlane Enchantress who just kind of takes over that whole area. It's like, this is my map now, you know? Just stay away. And Roche, like, what's the deal?
Well, Reborn don't really have, I guess they have an okay team for doing it. But I think they're much more concerned about just controlling the Roshan pit and making sure that, I think that was actually one of the big advantages of their Weaver Enchantress is the fact that they control their offlane tower, which is normally not that big of a deal. You can easily give away offlane towers, more so on the Radiant side, but still, like, Dire side Radiant Tier 1 isn't very important, but when you're up against a Radiant side Ursa, and that Roshan becomes such a focus point, keeping those the middle tower and bottom tower alive actually means a lot. And it looks like Reborn are going to try and take Roshan for themselves now, denying that opportunity from VG Gaming with the Sven and with the Weaver. Should be pretty easy.
Yeah, no position to contest here.
JDH. Hit by the counter ward, quickly gets blown up right outside the Roshan pit. He scouted the fact that Reborn are doing it, but it doesn't really matter.
Okay, almost got disconnected there. We're good, we're good. So put that right on. No, no. Got ourselves the Aegis, the Midas. He's got his Yule Scepter. That's the other thing that CTY, I believe, sometimes gets. I think that's actually the next item. It's the Yules instead of the Force Staff that people used to get. if I recall correctly. It's pretty comical. it's quite the build.
All right. Trust in CTY.
I kind of like it. I mean, what is it? 8% damage? It's pretty big with that big nuke.
CTY biding his time. Waiting for the opportunity to jump. Yang just threw out a swarm. They do manage to get the tornado EMP onto two, quickly killing HYM as the urn. Cold snap tick. No! Maxed out Voodoo Restoration is enough. He stays alive. Reborn continue their push, though, knowing that one hero is gone from the fight already. They're going to leave No-No on the front lines, daring Vici Gaming to try and initiate on him instead. They just go for the deny. Burning successfully claims that one. JDH sits on the side here. Top tower is under
attack. Jeez, ROTK just patiently waiting with that doom. Can't find a good opportunity. They don't have anything to punish this really either. I suppose CTY is kind of close to being able to.
Yeah, I don't think they should try and fight at all, honestly. The BKB complete on ZYF. He's about to get level 16 as well. I think you just have to wait out this Aegis.
Yeah. They even like, all right, they're going to smoke up, but basically like just go anywhere that ZYF's not. I guess would be the plan.
Or maybe they can get the disables on him first. Before the BKB goes down, let's see this smoke. Not really heading the place that they want to go. This tier 1 tower being up at mid is such a problematic force. It closes off so much of this smoke rotation.
Is that ward going to be inside the sentry?
They're spotting No-No. Yep, looks like it. And so is JDH.
Oh man, FY even gave it to ZYF.
Yeah, I was like, it's 50 gold. I guess every little bit helps, though. He's almost got his blink dagger. I'm presuming he's going to sell his calling blade soon for that. Haste. I guess time is kind of the essence because they want to utilize this Aegis, but they really need the blink dagger to make sure they can force fights.
Yeah, this should give them that timing, honestly. If they want to go for it, yeah, there it is. So, okay, so tier 2 mid, tier 2 top. Either one, a prime target here. And what's our counterplay here? We got the BKB up on burning, so that's pretty huge. If they can just get some sort of a bad engagement, maybe just burn that Aegis, then I'm feeling pretty good about this, but they're going right for the smoke play.
They're going to rotate bottom where Yang's already pushing out the lane. And smoke's going to pop on JDH. They don't have the counter wards for it. They have DDC who smokes, and he barely clips JDH, but he gets him nonetheless.
That was pretty sick. That was the optimal blink dust, I suppose. Works out. All right, who do you do here? They don't have the Lincolns yet. Is it on the courier? It must be close. Yeah, it's really close.
ZYF just jumps forward, goes straight for RTK, will manage to take him out. There's going to be no Doom available in this fight. No-No, Yule Scepter himself trying to get away from Burning, who will end up dying. No-No staying alive, keeping this Aegis intact. HYM digs himself into the trees, but eventually is going to be found here by ZYF.
Oh my god, it's a disaster.
Yep, that's three down with no buybacks. I think that's almost game. I think that's what it is. They can't go for more because the tier 2s are up, but losing your laner axe by 25 minutes this convincingly without any counterplay, that's what it's looking like. Unless Reborn can, unless Vici Gaming can stall out Reborn long enough for some of these heroes to come back.
Yeah, I like how CDY actually went for the more old school force staff so that he at least has some sort of like potential high ground play that he can live through, but not going to be able to get it off here. And Lincoln Spirit. Jeez. I don't know. They had this brief moment of like, okay, maybe they're doing it, you know? Some overextensions came out from the Evoker. A little bit too deep there. No-No did go down along with Yang at that one time at the Ancient Camp, but ever since then, we're just back on that same path. VGR's draft just looks so much stronger. I look at their draft and I go, that's a team that can win. I see how you're going to win this fight. I understand how your engagements are going to go. And then I look at VG's draft and I'm like, if you don't win the first 6 minutes, I don't know what you're going to do.
Yeah. It does seem that their lineups play a lot more heavily off of, like, player skill and execution, whereas you can very much see a strategy from Reborn.
That Enchantress Weaver is just... I mean, I know we already talked about it a couple times, but it really did help secure it. Like, as you mentioned, just holding onto that tower, really huge against the Roshan control. There was no chance at all for VG Game to go for the Rosh. And if you can't get Rosh on your Ursa, I mean, say it.
What's the point?
Yeah, like, why do you have an Ursa, basically? There's, I guess you have an Enchantress, but yeah, you can see it's not really the best laning counter early on. Like, in the later stages, like, yeah, you finally bring down this mega farmed Enchantress because you're an Ursa and that's sick. Definitely a-okay with that, but their lane got dumpstered. I mean, that tower going down that early, that is, like, not okay. Yeah.
Crystallis complete for ZYF. So he's on his way to one-shotting Fools quite soon. Yang's going to help out with that. With the Desolator, he should be able to complete quite soon. We also have an Ags on Nono, and if you guys haven't seen FY's Force Staff, that'll really help out against the Ursa. I'm waiting for them to pick up a gem, just because Reborn holds so much control as is. And the only way that they can really lose this game, in my opinion, is just pickoffs. So if they just kind of stay together and five-man with a gem, I think they're going to be just fine.
Yeah, it seems highly unlikely that you're going to lose a big team fight right now without... A lot of pressure is still on ZYF, but he's just been playing so solid these two games. Like, he can't really have a bad BKB, or the fight can go pretty poorly. You know, he dives in too deep, perhaps, gets controlled up, and then the Burning's just able to go to town. He's actually working on that Diffusal Blade, so one of the more popular Ursa builds lately. No time for a Morbid Mask. Too much of this AoE damage thrown about. The lances, understandable.
Trying rather, to catch.
Yeah, Mask and Mask. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, Mask of Madness would, I don't think it would be the item here for the Ursa in this game.
Cute, though, but not so much this time. He's under Sentry Ward there. Let's see, JDH would be alright. Oh, maybe not.
Oh, maybe not. Nope. Blown up by DDC. Meanwhile, they're going to initiate onto Burning. A Force Staff buys him a little bit of time, but somebody's going to catch up to him. It's going to be the Tornado. Finishes off Burning.
I mean, that's like it, right? Okay. Doom's out on end. There's no buyback.
Well, that's it for the fight, but that's also it for Reborn's push. They have nothing else they could do at bottom lane. They still need to deal with this tier 2 in mid. So I guess they lost Burning, but they're not going to lose a lane of Rex. They'll probably just lose their tier 2. There's the Dagon. Okay.
Oh, this was the stuff, man. This was the good stuff.
RTK? Is he not going to be able to get off of Doom? Or, sorry, he already got off the Doom, huh? Bottom lane, forgot.
Yeah. I mean, it was just so impactful, I'm surprised. That.
Yeah. I was just like, oh, that's right. I remember ZYF glowing red for reasons other than God Strength not so long ago. Well, this Paralyzing Cask is doing work. Looks like Reborn, again, not going to take any chances. They're going to back up and I think wait for Roshan. It's minute and a half, but they don't know that. Could be up now for all they know. Oh, well, would you have a look at that? That's a level 17 Invoker, who now goes down to 1.4 seconds for his Invoke. Now, if we only had an Octarine Core...
The dream, man.
Yeah, Arcane. The dream. A spell every second.
I like the early game, like Skywrath Mage, if you pick up on those things. It's like the most destructive support. All right, oh, yeah. CTY, it's happening top lane. Can he even kill him? No, there's like no way. He just ghosts the creeps. Forgot the Lincolns, obviously. The old Dagon not going to be helping out. Oh, man, I don't know. I just don't know. Questionable. It's just like, what was the play? What was the plan? It's hard to pick this kind of stuff out because sometimes you'll just win with the strap and you're like, oh, it makes sense. JDH, I think just got fingered.
Yeah, Burning tries to go on FY, but it doesn't work. Four staffs away. By God, ZYF almost just one shots a couple of heroes. Finally, does get the cleave on the Witch Doctor while he's beating on the mountain. Burning comes back, goes for FY. His sworn nemesis finally gets him in the end, and that's where they call GG.
Somehow Burning's courier went like past him. It's like getting cleaved and, well, just right click there by ZYF, so. I mean, that was pretty anticlimactic. Apologies to you guys. I mean, I'm sure we sound a little bit monotonous, but that was just a game that did not seem like there was any sort of a plan. I don't know how these lanes were supposed to work out. I guess it was just really solid play coming from VGI. I definitely don't want to understate that, because the way they controlled the Roshan pit, it kind of neutered this entire like potential their draft. You could definitely see, get the Blink Dagger up on the Ursa, he gets that Roche, you go really aggressive like into the Enchantress, beat her down a couple times, go find that Sven in the jungle, you kill him. But couldn't quite get those pieces to fit together, and VG Gaming, just some serious OP heroes, serious solid plan, executed extremely well in that offlane to hold onto it with the Enchantress and the super early tower for the Weaver. It's like a riskier pick with the Weaver, because you're not getting that classic initiation or offlaner kind of a thing, but it worked out.
Okay, well, that's just our first series of the day. We are going to have another series for today, and I believe that's going to be newbie versus CDEC. So a lot of people have been hyping up the new CDEC. I don't know. How do you feel about it, Mompax?
I mean, I'm just I'm holding judgment after some of the games that I've been watching. I'm just gonna wait to see how teams start playing. It's questions have been raised today.
Yeah, I think CDEC could be one of the new. One of the winners of the shuffle. It was kind of hard to say, just right, you know, because they lost aggressive, and I'm not sure. I think that hurts them almost a little bit too much, but still, Super, Rabbit, Yao, those three joining the team, I think, is significant upgrades. But they're also going to be facing it against Newbie, who I'm quite excited for, because that's the team that picked up KP. Woo! So.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Huh.
Okay, all right.
Went from can't say whips to MVP Phoenix to that e-home team that didn't really get any ground at all to now Newbie. Big steps for him. Big steps.
On the road.
Yeah. So that is definitely going to be, I think, almost a more interesting matchup than this one. This one's just fun, right, because it's VG Gaming versus VG Gaming Reborn, but people very much expected Reborn to be able to come out on top. Newbie versus CDEC, I think, is going to be a lot harder to tell. And that is going to be starting in 50 minutes. So we are going to have a very long break. And we will be back with our second series of the day.